Thanks. My name is Felipe. This experiment was made only in economic students or other types of students?
The whole university. Okay. It's a very large university. You can think of essentially kind of like Los Angeles. So, privileged university in a higher world place.
So I was wondering if you can tell us a little more about your contribution to the literature, because at first I think you mentioned briefly that you have a different setting, it's the first one in a developing context, so I was wondering how are your results different from being in a context where you would expect people to have different preferences about inequality, how do they fit in the literature?
Yeah, so just replicate, so this is called the spectator design, this experiment, which was invented by the Norwegians and Bertil Tungoden and others. So just replicating a design that was shown to produce certain results from Norway in South Africa, we think it's already a contribution because there is no reason to assume that South Africans have the same. So let me conclude. So the design is the same, but they don't vary the same things. They have the spectator person, which is the third party thing, but they don't change inequality. They measure other things. They have many papers. So their contribution was to show how to estimate. I didn't show this because this is a 20 minutes presentation. There is a model in which essentially you're trading off fairness concern with personal utility. So in our experiment, the personal utility comes from the cost, and the fairness is when you want to split. So their contribution, I think it's an AER paper actually in early 2000s. Their contribution is, listen, I can estimate your individual level trade-off between fairness and personal utility. And so they do essentially the same experiment, but changing other variables. So we use the experiment, so contribution one, use similar design in a developing country. Contribution to varying other parameters within the same context of fairness versus personal utility. So we vary the distance in the payment split, which they don't, and we vary the personal cost directly. Usually cost is studied as a deadweight loss in a sort of, you know, welfare type of thing. We instead introduced this personal loss because, again, we were operating in a situation in which there was a large fraction of the population very worried about losing directly from redistribution. Yeah. Vito.
Patrizio, do you know if this result that I was really interested in, that the concern for the sources of inequality decreases when inequality, increases, no? So the high level of inequality, basically you don't care if that inequality is coming from one source or another. Is it a common? I haven't seen it before. I know it as a principle, as a normative principle in the theoretical literature, in the philosophical literature, but I haven't seen it in experimental evidence. Do you know if there are some other evidence? It's just first time.
The paper is that it's novel, because like you, we haven't seen it. Yeah, so right. We are actually making a big deal out of that result, because we think it's novel. This idea that when the difference is too much, that I don't care if you earn it or not. That's essentially making it.
Because I have a theoretical paper in which I propose that.
Oh, really?
Yes.
You
as a normative principle, so as a measuring. Or I should quote you as a justification of this. No, just curious if there are some evidence by the Norwegian guys about these things. Not on this. Okay, thank you.
Curious about some heterogeneities, so how the results vary, for example, by gender and race or family income, for example. Do you have any evidence?
Yeah, so we don't have family income, but we have race and gender. So we don't find differences in the redistribute, with the main variable, Y, in the propensity to redistribute by race, meaning that the results are the same across groups, whether the... Yeah, well, yes and no, meaning that they don't know the race of the other players, right? They have some priors of what those other two guys look like, right? So imagine you were doing the experiment here and you're told there is two Los Andes student in another room, they just finished their task. Then whatever your prior of what those two students look like, that's what you're gonna do, right? This is the phone telling me that I'm done, right? Okay, then, but yeah, so we don't have heterogeneity. Yeah. Thank you so much.
Thank you. I have many comments and many questions, but I'll just stick to one to let the others speak. So, your identification strategies in the spirit of Bleemer. So you compare your control are the ones that are not targeted by the policy. And then you have a strong assumption behind, which is that there are no effects on the control group, right? And I was wondering if you can check that in any way, if you did any, because I think there might be effect on these control groups, right? And then I think one way, the way Bleemer does it, so you always interpret the results in terms of gaps. So like by it reduces the gap in graduation or the gap in the labor market, but it does not mean that there are no effects in the control group, but I don't know. And I think it would be easier to understand your findings if I think the group to focus is the group that enters because of the quota, right? I also, the public school students that entered before and then they keep like the top ones, they are still there. I mean, I think the right way to write this paper is really splitting the two groups of public school students, the ones that are not affected. I mean, you still might expect some effect on them as you would expect an effect on the controls, but the real group that is entering because of the quotas, that's why I think you only find effects on those groups, and I think that's what I would expect. Yeah. And maybe, if you have time, can you clarify your last result? Because on the wages and on, because I think I saw something different.
So starting from the students who only entered UFBA because of the quota policy seem to earn smaller wages than those who would have entered even without the policy. Because it's Patricio's question. When the private school students, yeah. But then, let me see. Okay, so I have no effects for the public school students because I'm comparing them to the public school, to the public school students before the quota policy. I have the control group, which is the private schools, but they are constant on time, right? They analyze in relation to the non-quota students and two quota students who only entered because who would have entered even without the policy, because I find no effect for them, right?
Who is the red?
The red is the quota students who would have entered UFBA even without the policy.
So
I can write the equation down.
Yeah,
for the, okay, okay. Okay, okay, sure. And then when you said that maybe the private school students are like changing their behavior. So we have some descriptive analysis that we do an unconditional diff and diff on students' characteristics. And we find no difference for the non-quota students before and after the quota. The only thing we find is on wages, like wages, parents' income according to minimum wage, in minimum wage intervals. But then in this period in Brazil, we have a huge increase in real minimum wage. So we see a decrease in the interval. So I think. Yeah.
There are no difference in the composition of private students in that sector. But still, they can change the behavior during the university, right? They have a totally different peers. They are now studying totally
okay.
Different class.
Mm-hmm.
So they can, there might be peer effect. So in terms of graduation, in terms of peer performance in the labor market, I think they're going to be affected.
Okay.
And you cannot do anything about that, but
no.
What Bleemer does, because he also compares white and black in the US.
Mm-hmm.
He just, this is a
So you think I shouldn't sell as the it's a differential impact and not okay. Sure. And basically with this group is basically a placebo, right? Because if we did find evidence of impacts for this group, maybe we also would have impact for the non-quota group. So it works as kind of a placebo, but I agree with you that we should expect that all of the effects that we find would be in the group that only entered higher education because of the policy. And it's what we find in the paper.
We have three more minutes of questions. I have one. The quota actually, public school students with the quota have lower wages and also stay longer in college because they had to repeat. No, they had to retake the.
Graduation on time.
Okay. But how about the wages? Because I didn't understand. So the wages, yes. Okay.
En el momento en el que presenta los resultados de si hay una redistribución, una preferencia de las redistribuciones, ¿por qué no se muestran a todos los grupos dentro de eso? Digamos, había en el de las personas venezolanas solo estaban los venezolanos y creo que los pobres. ¿Por qué no se muestran también a los excombatientes y al otro grupo que tenías? No, el hecho de tener la apreciación de todos no haría los resultados más robustos. Muchas gracias.
And the question is about why you showed in this slide only two groups and not all of them. And these are the results of significant transfers or reallocation in this transfer for trust and the dictator game, and also reallocation for the preference distribution game for these groups, robust to the robustness checks. But in general, those who were not significant were positive. And what we, as I didn't explain the game, but this is what we have. When it was locked, we have this, the participant, the observer, have to make seven decisions. It was poor, when it was internally displaced versus poor. And I say noise because in order to avoid confounding effects. Here, the participant, it was any citizen from the sample and had two characteristics that were fixed. So it was this player two was low socioeconomic status, low level of education, and this was the characteristic that we were changing. So we didn't enhance what we wanted to see, right? That's why we have these pairs. And what I showed are those who were significantly with a sizable effect. Any
clarification only? So you had 900 people. They watch a video. Where are they? And then they do some games right after watching the video. And then you link to the World Value Survey. So that's, I don't know how you do that, by the way. And then. So let's just stay on the games, where they are, how long after, and so on.
I like these questions, because then I can talk more. These are the procedures. It was an all, pandemic. So we couldn't do field work in person. So we managed to have access to the World Value Survey panel in Colombia. And from there, we sampled 900 people. And these participants saw the video online. They entered. They were paid if they were there all the time and answered everything. So we guaranteed that they saw the video, then answered the questions, played the games. And 1 week later, they received their payment. They were very sure that actually, and after that, once they received, we got their decisions. We matched them with the decisions of the ex-combatants and the migrants who played, who were there, and they received their payment too. So it was a asynchronous matching when we were conducting the experiment. That's one of the advances that I actually didn't mention, but Santiago, who is the cognitive scientist, is so happy because he worked so hard in order to get these in tablets, I mean, the same idea, and feasible for the finger movement tracking, tablet, mobile, computer, any, it was the same, and it was used.
Their own data,
cell phone data. Yes, no. Ah, well, yes, yes. But they belong already to the panel, so they know already how it works. We were assured that they never participated before in a study relating migrants, but... Any? Okay. Well, I think that's...
How many people, like how many bike migrants are in my neighborhood, or how many IDPs, to see if like that, exposure to them like makes you.
No, we have a regional. These are representative sample at the regional level. We have their city when they were born, and we also have where they live, and we have where they took where was the place? I mean the. Coordinates of where they were, but we cannot relate. I mean, it will be we will need to extract better to see if we can relate that in terms of exposure. But we did ask them if they were in contact or if they had an experience, direct experience with actually with an ex-combatant or with a migrant. No. Well, we control for that, but no, actually no, and there were very few, and it's understandable. I mean, it was direct contact, so there is whatever the participant interprets in terms of direct contact. Still, the video, as it is structured, is with people that were in very close contact with the in-group, with the out-group member. That means that for the participant receiving information in the video about another Colombian that actually that did have direct contact will have informed somehow the participant about the closeness or the ability to integrate of the out-group member. Yes?
Can you repeat how you measure
impact? Sorry?
How you measure
impact? Oh, yes. Sure. Very happy to do that. This is the panel. This is a whole sample of the tools that we used. These are the humanization, Platon dehumanization, and the feeling thermometer is what I was saying is the closest to what we call emotions in economics. Meta dehumanization is first order beliefs in terms of dehumanization. It's like dehumanization is thinking. Is I'm the participant and I say. In which category I consider or I perceive the out-group member. And this very aggressive image is actually very well validated all over the world in many intergroup conflicts. And it was one of the main points in our video. Also, what we have is direct empathy, no, this is not, sorry, malleability. Was also key for the video, and willingness to integrate and the ability to integrate. So what we have here is the measures that we use in the survey, post-game survey, to see if actually this did happen. It was an improvement of that, and we found it. What we've Blatant dehumanization is our district four characteristics. The degree is a like Hertz scale of the degree of how I perceive the other. The feeling thermometer is a measure of warmth. these meta perceptions are related to the perceptions that the other thinks about me. Collective blame is how the out-group member feels guilt about what it has done. For migrants is or the situation. For the migrants was not the case, but it is very important for ex-combatants to have information about that. Direct empathy is the family-related situations or very direct contact. If the participant considers a threat when interacts with a out-group member, these are an hypothetical situation of hiring, which is for some psychologists a behavioral measure, but I already convinced my colleagues that no. Malleability, as I just described it already, and exposure to violence. Very expensive, very extensive.
Can you answer this question still on the tablet?
Yes.
After they watch the video and after they've done the games?
Yes.
How long were they on these tablets? I mean, this is a big 68. You're giving them $20 for 68 minutes.
Well, that's here.
Oh, well, here the exchange rate help a lot.
Okay. Yes. More exposure to violence make people more empathetic, or?
Oh, no, this is, yes, well, this is part of a, we use it as a control too. Okay. But this is actually a survey measure in terms of not perceptions or psychological attitudes, but if I have been exposed, for example, to, in Colombia, ex-combatants, to know how it works, the dynamics between my relationship with ex-combatants, is if I've been a victim of conflict, or if someone in my family has been a direct victim of conflict. Okay, thank you. Well, about result, we have questions about exposure to violence in general, because when you are exposed to violence, you trust less in general. So it's a mechanism for self-protection that you don't trust anyone. So it's very important to know if you have suffered or not in order to trust. Thank you.